In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about enzyme kinetics. What is enzyme kinetics? The word kinetics means related to the speed. So, enzyme kinetics means it is a study of speed, or you can say velocity, of enzyme catalyzed reaction. Now, to study about enzyme kinetics, let's do one very simple experiment. In this experiment, what I am going to do is that I will keep molar concentration of enzyme at a constant level. Remember one thing, that whenever anything is represented in such a square bracket, that means we are talking about its molar concentration. Here E represents enzyme and this square bracket represents its molar concentration. So here molar concentration of enzyme is kept at a constant level, whereas we will keep increasing the substrate concentration slowly. Okay, while doing this experiment, we will measure its velocity, and this velocity is going to be initial velocity because we will measure the velocity as soon as this enzyme and substrate are mixed up, right? So that initial velocity is represented by V0. So the finding will be like this in a graphical manner. Suppose this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. On the y-axis, we take initial velocity, that is V0. And on the x-axis, we take a substrate concentration. One thing is obvious, that as we go on increasing this substrate concentration, velocity will also increase. So initially, the graph will be like this straight line. But after some time, after some level of substrate concentration, what will happen? This line, it will lose its slope and it will slowly become almost horizontal. Remember, I am saying that it will become almost horizontal, but never completely horizontal. See, what will happen? Slowly and steadily, it will move upwards, but at a very lesser speed. So it seems that this line is little bit moving on upward side, and it is trying to approach this line. Okay. So at some very high substrate concentration, almost near to the infinity, this line will touch it. Okay. And this line, it represents a maximum speed. So we call it as a Vmax. Remember, theoretically, this line, this blue line, it will never touch this green line, which represents Vmax. And why it is happening so, that we will see in a little while. Now, in this enzyme kinetics, two scientists, they are named as a Leonor Michaelis and Mode Menten. This scientist, Leonor Michaelis and Mode Menten, they both had done pioneering work in the enzyme kinetics. What they had done, they proposed one simple model. And in this simple model, what happens? Enzyme E reacts with the substrate S reversibly and forms enzyme substrate complex. This enzyme substrate complex further goes into the reaction, and free enzyme is released and product is released. So substrate is converted to product, but enzyme is released in its original form. This ES is highly unstable enzyme substrate complex, and in honor of Leonor Michaelis and Mode Menten, this ES complex is sometimes referred to as a Michaelis-Menten complex. This Michaelis and Menten, both for this simple model, they given a formula to calculate velocity. And here also it is initial velocity. So V0 is equal to Vmax, which is a maximum velocity, into molar concentration of substrate, divided by Km, which is Michaelis and Menten constant, plus substrate concentration. So this formula for counting or calculating initial velocity was given by Michaelis and Menten. So here all the variables are V0 is the initial velocity, then Vmax is the maximum velocity. Then square bracket S is the molar concentration of substrate S. Then Km is the Michaelis-Menten constant. Sometimes this Michaelis-Menten constant, it is also called as a Briggs and Haldane's constant. It is Briggs and Haldane constant. So remember, both this Michaelis-Menten constant and Briggs and Haldane constant both represents Km. Now one thing, that in this simple model, Michaelis and Menten proposed that this reaction, this forward reaction where enzyme and substrate forms enzyme-substrate complex, this reaction, its rate constant is small k subscript 1. Whereas this reverse reaction where enzyme-substrate complex dissociate, its rate constant is small k subscript minus 1. Whereas for this reaction, the rate constant is small k subscript 2. And this Michaelis-Menten constant, that is Km, it is mathematically equal to k minus 1 plus k2 divided by k1. So if you look closely, k minus 1 and k2 both are away from this enzyme substrate complex, right? This enzyme substrate complex, on this left side it is k minus 1, and on this away on right side is the k2. So k minus 1 and k2, that is away, divided by this k1, which is going towards the ES complex. So it is 2. So simply by this method also, you can remember this formula of Michaelis-Menten constant. Now this formula is not less than a magic. Okay, it was a result of pioneering work of Leonor Michaelis and Maude Menten. Let's see why it is not less than any magic. Because, see, there are several important conclusions can be made out of this important formula. So let's discuss about its first conclusion. Now to understand its first conclusion, let's suppose that what will happen when the initial velocity is one half of its maximum velocity. Here in the graph, as you can see, that this is the maximum velocity where this line is trying to touch. Okay, so the exactly half of this Vmax, if we take it somewhere over here, it falls. So what will happen when this V0 is at this point? Let's try to find out from this formula. So here we will keep in this formula, here we will keep V0 is equal to 1 half Vmax. So let's put up this value in this formula. So V0 is equal to 1 half Vmax is equal to, the right side will be the same. So Vmax into substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. So Vmax can be cancelled. So 1 half is equal to substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. If we do cross multiplication, then 1 into Km plus substrate, that is Km plus substrate concentration, is equal to 2 into substrate. So 2 into substrate. So this S can be transferred to this side and with a minus sign. So Km will equal to 2S minus 1S. So it will result in substrate concentration. So as we can see, Km is equal to substrate concentration. So what conclusion can be made? See, Km is equal to substrate concentration when velocity is exactly half of the maximum velocity. So the conclusion is that Km is nothing but the substrate concentration. It is a substrate concentration. But when? It is a substrate concentration when velocity is one half of its maximum velocity, right? So in this graph, see, if this is one half of Vmax, then if we look at the corresponding point on the substrate concentration side, so whatever the substrate concentration is there, it will be equal to Km value, right? So this very important conclusion can be made. So now let's try to understand about this Km little bit more. Suppose we have two enzymes, E1 and E2. These two different enzymes are there, but for both of them, maximum velocity, let's say it is 100. I'm not writing a unit, as these are all hypothetical numbers and we try to understand this game. Okay, so suppose both of this enzyme E1 and E2, they have a maximum velocity of 100. And let's say that Km value for this enzyme E1 is 10, whereas Km value for this enzyme E2 is 20. So obviously, when substrate concentration is 10, at that time, this enzyme will have its velocity will be 1/2 of its Vmax, right? So it is going to be 50. Whereas on this side, this enzyme E2, at a substrate concentration of 20, its velocity is going to be 1/2 of this, that is again 50. So as you can see, to produce the same velocity by this both enzyme, little substrate is required for E1 and more substrate is required for E2. That means if Km value is lower, so what will happen? This substrate will have a more affinity as compared to this side, which has larger Km value, right? So whenever Km value is larger, the substrate will have a less affinity. We can conclude that here affinity of substrate is more towards the enzyme, and so even little bit of substrate is going to give you the same velocity as compared to the higher Km value. So remember, lower the Km, higher affinity of substrate with enzyme, and vice versa, that higher the Km, that means lower the affinity of substrate with enzyme. So this second important conclusion can be made. The third important thing is that Km value of any enzyme is constant or fixed. It is a characteristic of that particular enzyme. It is like a thumb impression or signature of a person. For a person, signature or thumb impression is unique to them, right? So similarly, for any enzyme, their Km value is going to be unique for them. Now again, coming back to this formula, that we can estimate all the parameter, but what about Vmax? Because by this graph, it seems that we can never estimate this maximum velocity. So how to determine this maximum velocity? Again, that determination can also be decided by this Michaelis-Menten equation. See, let me rewrite this Michaelis-Menten equation. So the equation is V0, that is initial velocity, is equal to Vmax into substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. Let's take inverse on both the side. So V0 will become 1 by V0. And here, this lower part will be over here, that is Km plus substrate concentration divided by this upper part on the lower side. So Vmax into substrate concentration. Here I had done nothing. I had just rearranged this formula, right? Now let's separate this plus sign. So what will happen? 1 by V0 is equal to Km divided by Vmax into substrate concentration plus this substrate concentration divided by same, that is Vmax into substrate concentration, right? Now this substrate concentration can be cancelled over here. So here what will happen? 1 by V0. I will write this Km by Vmax in a bracket. So Km by Vmax in this bracket into 1 by substrate concentration. So I had separated this substrate concentration, right? Plus here substrate concentrations are cancelled. So simply it is 1 by Vmax. If you closely examine this rearranged Michaelis-Menten formula, you will find that Km and Vmax both are constant for any given enzyme. And Vmax is obviously, it is also a constant for any given enzyme. So this bracket part, this one and this one, both bracket part, they are constant. Whereas velocity and substrate both are variable. So this formula, it looks like this simple linear equation, that is y is equal to ax plus b. Here a is constant and b is also constant, whereas x and y both are variable. So it is matching with this upper formula. This y, which is variable, it is matching with 1 by V0, and this x, it is matching with this 1 by substrate concentration. So this x and y and 1 by S and 1 by V both are variable. Whereas this Km by Vmax, which is matching with the position of A, and 1 by Vmax, it is matching with the position of this B. This red highlighted part is the constant, right? So this will give a straight line, okay? So if we take a graph paper, suppose this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis, right? Now we do a series of experiment just like this, that we take a series of substrate concentration and measure initial velocities, right? But here what we will do, we carry out the same experiment, but instead of substrate concentration on the x side, we will take this 1 by S. So 1 by substrate concentration on the x axis as it is matching with this, and on the y axis we take inverse of velocity. So on the y axis we take 1 by V0. So we will do this experiment. So we will get a different value according to reciprocals of substrate concentration with reciprocals of velocity value, right? So suppose one point is over here, second point is over here, third point is over here, and fourth point is over here. And as this formula is suggesting, it is going to be straight line, right? Now I can project this line in a straight manner on both the side, right? Now what do you think about this graph? You might think that this is just an aesthetically good looking graph rather than this, as this was a curved line, whereas this one is the straight line. But no, it is not as simple as that. See, whenever there is a linear formula of y is equal to ax plus b, we can easily predict its x-intercept and y-intercept. See, x-intercept for the y is equal to x plus b is going to be minus b by a, whereas y-intercept is going to be b. So in case of this x-intercept minus b by a, so here b corresponds to 1 by Vmax. So here minus 1 by Vmax divided by this a. So a is Km by Vmax. So Km by Vmax. We can cancel out this Vmax, Vmax, and so we get a minus 1 by Km. This is the x-intercept. So where does this line is intercepting with x? It is at this point, right? So this point will give you a value of minus 1 by Km, and so we can solve that and get a value of Km. What about y-intercept? Y-intercept is equal to b. And in this formula, the value corresponding to B is 1 by Vmax. So it is going to be 1 by Vmax. So y-intercept is this one. And this value will give you a value of 1 by Vmax. Right? So here, as you can see, as an experiment, we get this value, this value, this value, and this value. And then we had drawn a straight line out of that. And wherever it intercepts with the y, we get a value of 1 by Vmax. And so obviously we can also get a value of Vmax. See, over here in this graph, we are not able to get the value of Vmax. But in this graph, we can easily get a value of maximum velocity. Instead of directly taking substrate and velocity value, we are taking inverse or reciprocal of both of these, right? So because of this reason, this graph is also called as a double reciprocal plot. This graph is also called as a lineweaver burk plot. Lineweaver burk plot. So this completes our discussion about enzyme kinetics. I hope that everything is clear. If you still have any doubt or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.